to the Civil War Guru Show. My name is Steve Munson, and I am the Civil War Guru. And the day I have in front of me is a fabulous find. This is a model 1827, 24-pound Coehorn Mortar. This particular mortar was made in 1827. And we're going to get up close and personal on it with Brendan Cole. We're going to see the maker's mark, which is U.S. Arsenal, Washington. We're going to see the date, 1827. We're going to see the serial number, which is marked on there, which is serial number 3. It's on the muzzle here, and serial number 3 is on the base. This particular mortar has had several things that's happened to it in its lifetime. First, they tested the gunpowder, the strength of gunpowder. This is a beefed up version. They would use this to see how much gunpowder and what it would take to project and hurl a projectile as far as it could. And they used different variations, different levels, and different types of gunpowder. And this was used in 1827. It was also used in a test in 1840. Then after that, it was shipped down to South Carolina, and it ended up in our arsenals there at the beginning of the Civil War. Now, when the Civil War started, this Coehorn here did not have the handles and this particular apparatus here. This was added by the Confederates down in Charleston. And if you go down to the Charleston, you travel around there and look at several cannons, you'll see these type of hardwares that's been applied. And this was applied so that they could elevate this particular cannon. Normally the Coehorns have a swivel point down here at the base. This has a solid base. And this solid base, again, was for testing. But the Confederates applied the handles up here, because normally these are on a wood sled, and there's 4 handles for 4 people to carry it. This particular thing weighs 290 pounds. This apparatus here, which Brendan will get a close-up of it, the handles, was all applied in Charleston. Now, the last thing that happened was this particular Coehorn here was used at the battle, and I'm going to read it off here. It's called Burdan's Causeway in 1864. And it's an obscure battle on John Island. Now, John Island is a part of Charleston. It's the southern part of Charleston. And it's nothing but swamps and plantations. And there's a river called the Stono River. And they built an earthen fort. And that particular fort, and I'm going to read that name too, is called Telhome. And this was part of Fort Telhome, which was an earthen fort. And it had 17 emplacements for guns, for cannon, and overlooked this river. Well, in 1864, the Union troops come in and decided to take this. This was a prelude for Sherman coming into Charleston. And so they had 4,000 primary Union troops and 1,000 reserves. And I'm going to give you a list, read off this list, of the Southern boys that were there. And here's some of the troops that were there. Give you a kind of highlight of this obscure battle. On the Union side, it was the 3rd, the 57th, 144th, 157th New York Regiments, the 4th Massachusetts Cavalry, the 8th and 104th Pennsylvania Regiments, colored troops. Down in South Carolina, they used colored troops. The 9th Maryland, 26th New York, 2nd South Carolina, and also the 34th South Carolina. Now on the Confederate side, we had the 1st Georgia Regulars, 4th Georgia Cavalry, 32nd Georgia Regiment, 47th Georgia Regiment, the Stono Scouts, the Washington Light Artillery, the Inglis Light Artillery, and the 2nd South Carolina Cavalry. Well, this battle, like I say, I just found out about this thing by researching it, and it was a tremendous battle down in the swamps, and the Union forces just absolutely just got decimated down there and retreated. And it was one of the great accolades of this particular earthen fort. And I think that surprised me, and a lot of people don't know that they were trying to take Charleston, South Carolina from all sides, not only from Fort Sumter sitting there in the harbor, but also from the inland side. And that's where this particular cannon was found, near there on a plantation in 1960, and it was retrieved and saved, and it's got wonderful marking. And it's got wonderful patina. This is a super, super rare Coehorn. And especially with the Confederate usage adds a lot to it. So I'm going to get Brendan Cole up here, and he's going to get close on it so you can see some of this handmade apertures that have been added to this thing, and also the serial number so you can see that. But this was bought to me by a friend of mine, and Brian, and he wanted me to evaluate it because we've handled several cannons. And this is one of the unusual cannons that I've actually ever handled. And Coehorns are rare. The only other iron one I know of is on display at the Petersburg Museum, and it's iron. And it's serial number, I think it's serial number 7. And this is serial number 3. So this thing's early, and it's really neat. But I want you to take a look at the base, because the base is what separates us from the other Coehorns, because it doesn't have that bar in the back that pivots. And this aperture does that for it. So it's really unique. And value-wise, you know, these things, especially with Confederate usage, where they got a documented Confederate usage, can go from $25,000 up. So from the Civil War guru, have a great day.